The scenery is beautiful, but the weather is not. Despite the downpour, dozens of volunteers have turned up to search the shoreline.
We came up with the idea that we would get out and try to clean up the beaches in one particular area and get it all off there before the masses of this tsunami debris starts coming in.
Much has crossed the Pacific following the 2011 earthquake and subsequent tsunami.
It says Psycholac float made in Japan, 300 something.
There's Japanese writing on the bottom. Yeah, this is from Japan.
Danielle Durant and her father have a personal connection to the disaster in Japan 2 years ago. She lives in Canada now, but was living and working as a teacher in Fukushima when the earthquake and tsunami hit.
Well, I'm just hoping that I can, you know, send it back to my village and town, and that they can, you know, inform the kids of kind of how big the footprint of this thing is. That, you know, their teacher returned to Canada in August, and now she's picking up their garbage, well, the garbage from the tsunami, in her home area or whatever. So I'm hoping that they can kind of share that with the kids out there.
Renee Wazink is on a national committee that is organizing how Canada will deal with what could be heading to their shores.
You know, when the tsunami debris was washed out to sea in Japan, there were a lot of industrial areas. So we're, you know, we do have a worry about, you know, drums with various chemicals, you know, containers, you know, containing all sorts of toxic materials. So that's certainly a concern.
The best known accidental import was a Harley Davidson motorbike, which landed up the coast in British Columbia. It's now in a museum. Few other items have been traced back to their original owners in Japan. Artist and biologist Peter Clarkson collects what comes ashore and makes art out of it.
The idea would be to incorporate it into a small Japanese garden and have a place where people could go and contemplate the event and the tragedy itself.
The Japanese government has given Canada $1 million to help with the cleanup. Tofino is usually a surfing destination, but in the months ahead, residents will be keeping their eyes open for what else might be washing up here. Brandi Yanchik, BBC News, British Columbia, Canada.